Whether you're a first-time menstrual cup user or you've been using menstrual cups for a while now, I'm sure you've had the question, what on earth do I do with my menstrual blood when I am camping in the wilderness? I know that I've had that question before, and I'm here to say that I have all the information that you'll need on how to properly dispose your menstrual blood when you're in the wilderness, and I'm going to talk all about what on earth a CATHOLE is and how to utilize that when you're camping. So let's jump right in. A CATHOLE is something that explorers use to dispose of things that we don't want contaminating the water systems, such as bowel movements, menstrual fluid, or dirty water that you might have used to wash dishes or clean. And I'm going to talk about how to use a CATHOLE to dispose of your menstrual fluid. The first step, and something that is super important, is you gotta make sure that your CATHOLE is at least 200 feet away from any natural water sources. If you don't know how far 200 feet is, that's about 70 steps. And the reason for this is because we don't want any of our fluids contaminating any water sources. So make sure that you plan your CATHOLE a safe distance away from any running water. Now that you've determined that you're at least 200 feet away from any major water source, you're going to want to figure out where exactly your CATHOLE is going to be. My advice is to look for a place that is out in the open, not too close to any rocks or trees, because healthy soil and direct sunlight help the fluids to decompose quickly into the earth. Now it's time to empty your cup into the CATHOLE. Before you remove your cup, make sure that your hands are super, super clean. This is important whether you're in the wilderness or at home or in public. No matter where you are, make sure your hands are squeaky clean. So clean your hands and now empty your cup into the CATHOLE. After you empty your Pixie Cup, you're going to want to give your cup a really good rinse. I recommend that you pack a bottle with you, maybe something like a hydro flask where you can have some water on hand to rinse out your cup. And if you don't have water with you, you can use a Pixie Cup wipe. Just make sure that you pack that back with you and dispose of it when you're done camping. After you've reinserted your cup, you're going to want to cover up your CATHOLE using all the dirt that you previously scooped out. I'd cover the hole and then throw some sticks and leaves on there to make it look more natural. If you've used a Pixie Cup wipe or any toilet paper, make sure to pack that back with you and dispose of it when you're done camping. And other than that, you're ready to roll and you are done. And it was easy as that. After I learned this knowledge, I am no longer stressed about camping with my Pixie Cup. I don't know why I ever thought it would be an issue, but it's truly as easy as building a CATHOLE and then disposing of your menstrual blood in the CATHOLE, burying it, and you're good to go. Pixie Cups are amazing because they give you back the freedom to be able to enjoy camping trips, enjoy river trips, or anything where out in the wilderness, because you don't have to stress about tampons and what you're gonna do with them. You can simply empty your cup into a CATHOLE, which is absolutely incredible. And I have a couple questions for you guys today, and those are, have you ever used your Pixie Cup in the wilderness? How did you handle it? And what are some tips that you have for those of us that have yet to do it? Go ahead and leave us a comment below.